Dear students, welcome to plug setting multiplier, time multiplier setting equations and numericals part 3. First numerical, an earth fault develops at point F on the feeder. The fault current is 16,000 ampere. Here bus bar A and bus bar B with two breakers and two CTs. The ADMT relay at point A and B fed via 800 by 5 CTs. So these both CTs have ratio 800 by 5. Now the relay at B has plug setting 125%. Time multiplier setting is 0.2. The CB takes 0.2 seconds to clear the fault. Relay error in each case is 0.15 seconds. For plug setting of 200% on the relay A, we have to determine the minimum time multiplier setting on the relay for it not to operate before the CB at B has cleared the fault. A relay operating time is same on the curve. Now, how can we solve this example? So the relay setting is 125% given and CT ratio is 800 by 5. Now we have to find out the pickup current. So I pickup is 800 into 125% means 1.25. So 800 into 1.25. So relay setting is 1.25 means 125%. So 800 into 1.25. So PSM plug setting multiplier is equal to fault current upon pickup current. So 16,000 is our fault current and 1000 ampere is our pickup current. So PSM will be 16. Now operating time of relay, we will use equation that we have earlier discussed, that 3 upon log 10 PSM into TMS. So 3 upon log 10 16 into 0.2. So we will get 0.5 seconds. Now relay operating time of relay B is 0.5 second. Discrimination time, it is equal to time for breaker at B plus twice relay error. So what is time for breaker? It is given as 0.2 second plus the ratio error is 2 into 0.15. So discrimination time is 0.5 second. Now the relay A does not reset until the breaker at B has interrupted the fault current. Hence time for relay A is equal to operating time for B plus discrimination time. Operating time for B is 0.5 second plus discrimination time is 0.5 second. So ultimately it is 1 second. So now the time for relay is 1 second. So for finding the PSM of relay A, we have to find out the plug setting multiplier and for that pickup current. So for finding the pickup current, 200% plug setting is applied to relay A. So for that, 1600 ampere will be our pickup current. So PSM is equal to fault current upon pickup current. Fault current is 16,000 ampere upon pickup current is 1600. So PSM will 10 ampere. From the curve of operating time at PSM of 10 for TMS of 1 is 3.0 second. Actually, current or PSM versus TMS graph has stated that for time multiplier setting of 1, the disk will take 3.0 seconds. It is already given in the graph. So, from the graph, TMS of 1 is equal to 3.0 seconds. But the time required for TMS of relay is actually 1 second. So, this is not the final operating time of relay A. We have to find it on the other way. Hence, time required for the time TMS for relay A is equal to, for 3 seconds, it is the time multiplier setting is 1. Then for 1 second, what is the time multiplier setting? Then 1 into 1 upon 3. So ultimately it is TMS is 0.33. So the minimum value of TMS of relay A must be 0.33. So conclusion is, when relay B will operate in 0.5 second and after the discrimination time over, relay A will be reset. Or if in 0.5 second relay B will not operate due to some malfunctioning, then relay A will be operate after 0.1 second or discrimination time after 0.33 second. So this is the operating time of relay A. A 20 MVA transformer, which may be called upon to operate at 25% overload. So it is meaning that 25% overload means total load is 125%. Feeds 11 kV bus bar through a CB. Other CB supply outgoing feeders. The transformer CB is equipped with 1000 by 5 CT and the feeder CB is 500 by 5 CT. So transformer CT has a rating 1000 by 5 and feeder CT has a 500 by 5 rating. It is connected with induction type overcurrent relays. Now the relays on the feeder CB have a 125% plug setting and 0.5 time setting. If a three-phase fault occurs of 7500 ampere flows from the transformer to one of the feeders, find the operating time for the feeder relay. We have to find the operating time of feeder relay first. Then the minimum plug setting of transformer relay. So we have to find out the plug setting of this transformer relay and its time setting, assuming discrimination time merging is 0.5 seconds. First of all, we will find out for the feeder. So for feeder, we have to find out the PSM, plug setting multiplier, that is fault current upon pickup current. So data given that in feeder relay, 125% relay setting is applied. So from that, we have to multiply the 125% with the primary current, that is 500. So fault current is 7500 upon 1.25 into 500. So we got 12. Plug setting multiplier of feeder relay is 12. And from the basis of
time multiplier setting operating time relay, the equation is 3 upon log 10 PSM into TMS. So data are, we put the data and calculate the operation time of relay, that is 1.11 seconds. So feeder relay operating time is 1.11 second if the 7500 ampere fault will occur. Now for the transformer, the rated current. So we have to find out the rated current because 20 MVA transformer is given. So from the 20 MVA and the 11 kV, we have to find out the rated current. So equation is kVA or MVA upon root 3 into kV. So kVA is 20 into 10 3 upon root 3 into 11. So 1049.72 ampere is our rated current. Now overload, 25% overload is given. Transformer is running continuously on 25% overload. So it is multiplied with the rated current. So ultimately 25% overload means 100% load plus 25% overload. So 125% total load. So now current is 1.1049.72 ampere into 1.25, that is percentage of 100. So our current from the transformer to feeder is 1312 ampere. PSM plug setting multiplier is I fault upon IP cup. So our overload, after the adding of overcurrent, the current will 1312 upon plug setting into 1000. So we have to find out the actual PSM. So the condition is the transformer relay must not operate to overload current. Transformer ka jo relay hai wo overload mein active nahi hona chahiye, kyunki overload is a normal or healthy condition, it is not a faulty condition. So जो उनका प्लग सेटिंग मल्टीप्लायर है वो 1 से ऊपर होना चाहिए. अगर 1 के अंदर आ गया तो वो ऑपरेट नहीं होगा. सो प्लग सेटिंग इनटू 1000, जो ये डिनोमिनेटर है प्लग सेटिंग इनटू 1000, इट इज ग्रेटर देन 1312. सो हमारा प्लग सेटिंग हो जाएगा, प्लग सेटिंग इज ग्रेटर देन 1312 अपॉन 1000. प्लग सेटिंग हमारा हो जाएगा 131%. सो 131% तो हम नहीं रख सकते बिकॉज वी हैव टू सेट इन द स्टेप्स ऑफ 25%. सो 150% इज वी कैन अप्लाई एट 150%. Now PSM is fault current upon pickup current. So 150% of plug setting we will apply here and PSM is 5. The operating time from the curve at PSM 5 and TMS of 1 is 4.7 seconds. So 4.7 seconds is given from the curve. Now actual operating time required is operating time of relay plus discrimination time margin. So operating time jo humne find out kiya hai wo hai 1.11 seconds and discriminative time margin jo humko diya gaya hai 0.5 seconds. सो ट्रांसफॉर्मर का जो रिले है उनका एक्चुअल ऑपरेटिंग टाइम जो रिक्वायर्ड है वो है 1.62 सेकंड्स। पर जो कर्व में दिया गया है वो अगर 4.7 सेकंड्स है वो एक 1 TMS के लिए है, तो हम ऐसे अप्लाई कर सकते हैं कि अगर 4.7 सेकंड के लिए TMS 1 होगा तो 1.62 सेकंड्स जो हमारा एक्चुअल ऑपरेटिंग टाइम आया है उसके लिए कितना TMS होगा, तो उसके हिसाब से हमारा TMS हो जाएगा 0.345। सो 0.345 सेकंड्स इज ट्रांसफॉर्मर रिले TMS, ओके, जो हमको फाइंड आउट करना था। थर्ड न्यूमेरिकल, टू रिलेज आर गिवन, ए बी एंड सी आर बस बार्स, फॉल्ट करंट इज 5000 एम्पियर, टू सिटीज आर देयर, द रेटिंग्स आर 1000/5, रिले R1 एंड R2 गिवन, R1 प्लग सेटिंग इज 100% एंड R2 प्लग सेटिंग इज 125%, R1 TMS इज 0.3 सेकेंड्स एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट R2 TMS। सो द टाइम ग्रेडिंग स्कीम हैज डिस्क्रिमिनेशन टाइम मार्जिन ऑफ 0.5 सेकेंड्स बिटवीन द रिले ए। द थ्री फेज शॉर्ट सर्किट एट F रिजल्ट्स इन अ फॉल्ट करंट ऑफ 5000 एम्पियर। सो व्हाट इज द ऑपरेटिंग टाइम ऑफ R2? सो फॉर दैट PSM ऑफ R1 इज I फॉल्ट अपॉन I पीक। सो 5000 अपॉन 100% प्लग सेटिंग ऑफ 1000 एम्पियर। सो वी गोट 5 एंड द ऑपरेटिंग टाइम दैट इज 3 अपॉन log 10 PSM इंटू TMS। सो अवर PSM इज 5 एंड ऑपरेटिंग टाइम इज गिवन दैट इज 0.3। सो इज इक्वल टू 3 अपॉन, ये कैलकुलेटर में किया है तो 1.28 सेकंड आ जाएगा जो कि है R1 का ऑपरेटिंग टाइम। नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट ऑपरेटिंग टाइम ऑफ R2 एंड फॉर दैट PSM ऑफ R2 इज PSM ऑफ R2 I फॉल्ट अपॉन I पिकअप। सो 5000 एम्पियर इज द फॉल्ट करंट एंड द प्लग सेटिंग इज 125% ऑफ 1000 इज द प्राइमरी करंट। सो 5000 अपॉन 1250 इज इक्वल टू 4, R2 का PSM आ जाएगा 4। नाउ फ्रॉम द कर्व PSM 4 के लिए एंड TMS 1 के लिए कर्व में दिया गया है 5 सेकेंड्स, बट एक्चुअल जो ऑपरेटिंग टाइम है उसमें R1 का ऑपरेटिंग टाइम प्लस टाइम ग्रेडिंग इज इक्वल टू 1.2 जो कि है R1 का ऑपरेटिंग टाइम जो हमने फाइंड आउट किया है, प्लस टाइम ग्रेडिंग जो कि दिया गया है 0.5 सेकेंड्स। सो 1.7 सेकेंड्स वी गोट एंड इफ ऑपरेटिंग टाइम ऑफ 5 सेकेंड्स हैव TMS 1 सेकेंड देन व्हाट इज द TMS फॉर 1.7 सेकेंड। सो ये इक्वेशन डाल के हम 1.7/5 0.34 सेकेंड्स हम ऑपरेटिंग टाइम R2 का कैलकुलेट कर सकते हैं। सो 0.34 इज द ऑपरेटिंग टाइम ऑफ R2। नाउ कंक्लूजन इज R1 का जो ऑपरेटिंग टाइम है वो है 1.2 सेकेंड आफ्टर द एडिंग ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन टाइम ग्रेडिंग दैट इज 0.5 सेकेंड। सो अल्टीमेटली R2 का पूरा ऑपरेशन जो है वो 1.7 सेकेंड्स में कंप्लीट हो जाएगा और उसके बाद जो R2 का पूरा ऑपरेटिंग टाइम है वो है 0.34 सेकेंड्स।